want to ask about the tafsir of Surah Tahrim. So I found two narrations in Sahih Bukhari. The first one says, narrated Ibn Abbas, I intended to ask Umar, so I said, who are those two ladies who tried to back each other against the Prophet? I hardly finished my speech when he said they were Aisha and Hafsa.
Hafsa and Aisha.
And then there's another, Aisha and Hafsa. And then the other hadith, right next near it, is narrated Umar, the wives of the Prophet, out of their jealousy,
Safiya,
backed each other against the Prophet.
Yeah.
So I said to them, it may be if he divorced you all that Allah will give him, instead of you, wives better than you.
Yeah.
So this ayah, 66:5, Surah Tahrim. So yeah. I want to ask you, what is the tafsir of the ayah? What actually happened? Like, how did
it's
they
actually
back each
both.
Other against the Prophet?
It is actually both. And it's not a conspiracy or anything. Okay? It's actually both. The first incident, which was between Hafsa and Aisha, radiyallahu anha, and when the Prophet ﷺ told her not to inform, and she happened to tell. So, فَلَمَّا نَبَّأَتْ بِهِ وَأَظْهَرَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ عَرَّفَ بَعْضَهُ وَأَعْرَضَ عَنْ بَعْضٍ. He told her, but not the entire narrative, not the whole story, just to let her know that Allah has informed him. And initially, he happened to divorce Hafsa radiyallahu anha. Then afterward, Jibril alayhi salam came from heaven and said, Allah is asking you to take Hafsa back because she's sawwamatun qawwama. She is a devout worshipper. She fasts a lot. She prays at night a lot. So he took her back as a wife. The Quran is educational. And that's why the revelation of the Quran was gradually over the period of 23 years. It was not like the previous books. So that's why most of the Quranic verses have what is known as the reason behind the revelations, as you just mentioned. So from these reasons of the revelations, we learn how to behave in our daily lives. Allah in the beginning said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ لِمَ تُحَرِّمُ مَا أَحَلَّ اللَّهُ لَكَ تَبْتَغِي مَرْضَاتَ أَزْوَاجِكَ. So Allah forbade the Prophet ﷺ, يعني he forbade the entire ummah. Again, it's making what is lawful, unlawful. Or making what is unlawful, lawful. Both are evil. And he began by the Prophet ﷺ. Like in the case of Abasa wa Tawalla, how to give da'wah and how to attend to everyone, even if people have no significance in the community. And what Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu say to his daughter is what is mentioned in the ayah, that Allah يعني will give him better than you. And Allah the Almighty stated that, and he confirmed that if you do not behave yourselves, Allah will give him better wives than you guys. Like in Surah Al-Ahzab, when Umar ibn Khattab entered upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam avoided his wives for a couple weeks, several days. Because they wanted nafaqa, they wanted to live يعني, a reasonable life. And the Prophet ﷺ was leading a humble life. So the Quranic verses came to give them the choice. إِن كُنْتُنَّ تُرِدْنَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَالدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أَعَدَّ لِلْمُحْسِنَاتِ مِنْكُنَّ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. So he started with Aisha radiallahu anha. He said, Allah is giving you the choice. If you like to live with me, you're going to continue with a humble life. If you like to live a luxurious life, I will give you the mut'ah after the marriage, some money, and you are on your own. So she said, of course I would choose you. I don't have to consult no one. And similarly did every one of the wives of the Prophet ﷺ. These reasons of the revelations are true and are also to educate us, not just narratives, to learn about events, but also to learn how to behave in our daily lives, irrespective of the dunya and the deen.